Okay, now we are going to repair the dot projector with a new method without removing the shield to solder the IC inside. Okay, we just need to add another tag, okay, another flex that is come with the chip. Let's look under the microscope. Okay, this little guy here fooled the motherboard, saying the face ID is still in good condition, so the face ID will be working again. But in this process, we need a new machine. We need to copy the face ID original code from this guy and then transfer to this chip. So put this aside. Let's bring in the new machine. Today I will be using the MiJing. It is called ZH01. This machine, it comes with two panels. Okay, one is for the battery. For the technician who have to do the battery service, you can use this panel. Today video, I will just use this one. This one is for the dot matrix. Okay, Lattice. So we come with a special port in here. It seems like charger port, right? It is very similar as the laptop. They provided a charging adapter that is similar as laptop voltage. This cable, okay, it come with the AC adapter. AC become DC. If you look at the output, it is giving 19 volt, 2.1A. What does it do? Why you need so much of power? It's because the old method, there's a MOSFET beneath this dot matrix. And there's another chip, it has the memory. He keep telling the motherboard, I have a problem. It keeps telling the motherboard, hey, I have been water damaged, I don't want this to be working. Actually, the face ID itself, the component, it still can be worked. So once it get a little water damage, or maybe the hand static, it can cause the face ID fail. The chip itself already remembered he has been damaged. So that's why our third party repair, like some developer there create a solution to change the chip inside and bypass the MOSFET, the power directly giving to the chip. So the new tools, we don't need to dismantle the dot projector. It's because we're using the high voltage power, 19 volt, coming in. And there's a button in the software, a skill switch. Okay, once you hit the button, he will inject the 19 volt voltage back to here to kill the MOSFET, and the power is going to be bypassed. As for the chip inside, it might be damaged, might be disabled. So once the chip is disabled, the face ID component, the infrared, it will still be working if you have a chip, a third party chip, tell him to be work. So this is where this guy come in. I think you know my explanation. I'm not going to drag too long about this. Let's show you how it is done. So first I'm going to test, is it really this guy is the problem? But I'm not going to use this one. I have a face ID tester in here. Right, it say iPhone 11 detected. NTC 29 Celsius temperature. So click the blue button. If I get all these, it means none of the light is working. And there's a Chinese word in here, say rong duan. Rong duan is mean fuse is broken. There's a fuse inside is broken. So for sure it doesn't work. First I'm gonna connect the PC. It is running the type C. And I don't know, is it my device has a problem because the screen is so dim. My eyes seeing the screen is very difficult to look what it display. So I'm gonna test again with these two. Look for iPhone 11 and plug it here. Okay, it has detected IPH 11. I press the test button, test finish, and there's a lot of red color line here. It say it is not working. Right? I do see blah blah blah. The four line isn't working. Alright, so I'm not gonna do diagnosis with this. I will use the PC. Okay, the MiJing is come with this software. We just open it. Okay, there's the iPhone connected, but don't worry about it. This is not related. We just click repair here. It forces us to log in with your email. I don't know what is the purpose of this. Maybe they want to collect the data so then they can advertise. Just click login. So I just click the test button here. It's the same message as I see from the device. Okay, I see fuse has a problem. Okay, all the light isn't working. So we need to back up this data. We have to click the read and then we save it aside. Just enter. After we're done, we unplug it. So now is the point that I use the third party chip put on here. And come back to this guy, click the test. It say normal, but there's no line. I need to write the data from the backup file earlier, which is this one. Okay, it is writing. Start to read, test complete. This step must need to be complete. I don't want you to kill the flags and you lost the data. So that's it for the data copying. Now the third party chip, it has the data. There's one more step. We need to kill the MOSFET in order to bypass the power. I should say we are killing not only the MOSFET, maybe the IC itself. And we are going to use this IC instead. So we are going to plug back this guy. And I'm going to test again before I do anything. Alright, so this button activate. It should be the button that kill it. So now is the point, plug in the power. I need to connect this phone. I need to unplug the unrelated things. Right, this is the iPhone that I am fixing the dot projector. Okay, I just need to click the cloud backup. Okay, he already has detected my iPhone that I'm fixing. Yeah, I need to connect the cable back. So this step is needed. Connect back the original flags. Connect the iPhone in the PC. Click the trust button. And then click this cloud backup. It is needed. After that, then this button will be available. So after you click this button, there's no going back. He will burn the IC inside. Then we will going to rely on the third party IC. So this is the MOSFET, this is the IC. Now I click the test button, you will see it still doesn't work, the fuse is broken. So click the activation now, it will kill the switch. Remaining activation to continue. Yes, he's using power to kill it. So my thermal camera saw there's a heat. Okay, so I click the test button again, but without the third party chip installed. So it will say I2C break. Okay? He doesn't detect the chip anymore. No more fuse broken or something message like that. So I unplug it. Connect to here. And then back to the machine, click the test again. Okay, do not press this button again. I don't want you to kill the third party flags. You don't want that. So click test. So everything is working, but there's a one line isn't working. He say abnormal. So we need to check our connection by reinstall the flags nicely. Again, there's still one light isn't working, right? Hopefully it is not overburned. So it is funny. I just found out if I connect the flags in the wrong way, one of the light will not be working. It won't say totally short or something. Okay, let me show you again. This is the original flags. So I need to make sure it is facing like this. Okay. Just now, when I test it, it is installed like this way. So it should be like this way by flipping the cable completely to this side. And then, do it like this way. Okay, get it? So this is the correct way of installing the cable. So inside here, you flip. Okay, it is very tricky. And then, put it back. Go to the software again and click the test. Okay, this time it says there's two lines isn't working. But let's make sure it is well connected. Ah, yeah. Now it is completely connected. Click again. Everything is normal now. So it is critical that we need to connect the flags in the correct way, or else some of the light will not be working. The first time when I do it, it's kind of like freak me out. You know, I'm afraid the high voltage will overpower and kill some of the lines, especially this part. Below this part is not replaceable. The MOSFET and the IC actually is replaceable. The lower part cannot be replaced. If you replace with other phone original part, your Face ID will be working, can be recorded, but it doesn't unlock. Okay? It doesn't unlock your face at all. This is what happened since the iPhone 10. So that's why I will apply that rules until today of the iPhone. Okay, so click the test again. Everything is good. I need to use another tester and plug it. This tester actually is more reliable because I can see the light, how the light appears. So if I click the test, okay, all four indicator, okay, and then it say Chinese word 正常, it means normal, okay, all lights they are working. If I look under the microscope, okay, this is what I meant. Look at this crystal, the prints. If I click the test, see, if you look carefully, actually there's a 1, 2, 3, 4 there come on in sequence. Never mind that, let's continue. So since we are keeping it as original, only with the third party flags right here, there's nothing need to alignment. So continue to install. Well, in here is a little tricky. We need to hide the flags between to the board. Okay, if I look under the microscope, the tricky part is here. Okay, I need to press it. Okay, hide the flags like this way. Insert all the way down. And then connect back to there. It's a bit hard to install, but we can get it. Okay. Yep. Take off the sticker. Clean up a little. Okay. So it will be on. I just test it without example everything. Okay, the message is not there anymore. Let's go to setting, general, about. If you still cannot get it work, you might still need to restore the software. But lucky the owner didn't restore or update when the Face ID is failed. So that's why it will immediately recognize the Face ID is back to working condition. The message is gone. Okay, if I open the camera, the portrait mode, selfie, we can see behind the object is blur. If I switch it to normal photo mode, behind the object is clear. If your dot projector is fine, when you switch to portrait, selfie behind will get blur. Okay, it means the light of here they are working. If you look under the microscope, you will see. See that? That few blinking red light. Okay? This one, Dot Projector. So, let's go to the face ID. I should continue to set up the face just in case it doesn't unlock. Alright, so let's look at the screen. See, it is already unlocked. I just light it up. So if I don't look at it, it will be locked. When you slide up, it asks for face ID. Okay, ask for password. So turn it off and look at myself. It is unlocked. Yep, it is done.
Hi everyone, I'm Lim. Just to let you know, today, June 2023, until today, this method of repair is still not support the iPhone 13 and iPhone 14. iPhone 13, they still need to replace the IC. Install the third-party IC inside. So the whole method is required to take out the flags dismantled from the crystal. The technique is still the same as the previous generation of the iPhone, the previous method that I always use. But the old method, they have two types. One is replace the flags that come with the IC. The second one is we replace the IC inside, keeping the original flags. And today of the video is the third method, which is we don't need to dismantle anything, no need soldering at all. We just install another flags on top of this original flags. Hopefully in future there will be support the iPhone 13 or newer model. I think it is my responsible to tell you this tool is come from a sponsor, MiJing. And you know there are some other brands that are making this too. So you have to do your own research, which one is better or are they the same. I only share such of information in my private study group to my own students only. So we're not going to share in the public. By the way, this tool is good to have it. It can save us a lot of time. So I guess that's it for the video. I see you on the next one. Bye.